The thing that struck me about your early upbringing, which is with a, you were brought up with your mother, grandmother, uncle, right?
Yes.
Absolutely, they all devoted themselves to you, didn't they?
Yes. Yes. They were. I mean, I was my grandmother's pet grandchild, and I was an only child, so my mother focused her whole life on me. My uncle did get married, but my uncle was, I mean, he was always the most special man in my growing up life. I absolutely adored him.
Uncle Charlie.
My Uncle Charlie, he was very smart and he was very funny and kind of silly, and I love that.
Do you think they spoilt you, or do you think they gave you confidence in order to get on with yourself?
Well, I don't think anyone ever gave me enough confidence, because I have more now certainly than I had then, but I still am not totally confident. They gave me tremendous support and tremendous love, and that certainly was helpful. I think I felt insecure, as any child of divorce does feel. My father did leave, and he wasn't around at all during my upbringing, my growing up.
Did you feel rejected by him?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
I don't think there's any way not to.
No.
And then finally, when I was grown up and had made my hit in Hollywood, and things were written about me, then he started to give interviews about me and how he disapproved of my being involved with a man old enough to be my father and this, that, and the other thing. And I thought, some nerve. I mean, really, a little late, folks, you know, for that comment.
You're right. So, when you made your hit in Hollywood, which I can only too well remember, because I was so jealous of you looking like you did.
I can't believe it.
True.
Yes. Oh, like I did, but not like I
do. Oh, do, did, same thing, same person. Now, when you did, though, you were a rather hard bitten, supposed to be, worldly woman who could take on any man, right?
Yes.
This was completely opposite to that girl.
Yes,
that
diametrically
tidy
opposed.
Jewish girl.
Yes.
That you were.
Yes, that yes? Scared, very scared little Jewish girl, right? Yes, I was supposed to be a woman of the world, a woman who had been around, who was in control of herself and knew how to deal with men. And of course, I was 18 when I went to Hollywood, and when I tested for that role, I then had my 19th birthday, and I really didn't know anything. I mean, I was a total innocent sexually, and I was a total innocent in life terms as well. I mean, how much can you know at that age?
But when you did, you see, but what was so astonishing about it then was, I mean, aside from the fact that that was a part you played, was it hard to convince your mother, for instance, who then saw you play this? And was she even disappointed in this sweet child that she adored playing that sort of woman?
Oh, no. My mother adored. She adored the success. She was so happy for me and proud of me. She loved that. She was quite wary of Mr. Bogart, as he was her contemporary, not mine. And
he was not Jewish, which must have
no,
been...
No, but that didn't worry my mother.
No?
My mother didn't care about that. My grandmother would have cared very much, but my grandmother had died just before that, so she didn't know about it. But she would have. She was Orthodox. My mother didn't have any feeling about that at all.
Why did you have strong feelings about it? I mean, was it because you felt that people were going to hold it against you being a Jew?
I felt that, well, I'd had a couple of experiences that had been unpleasant. Well, such as when I was a model on 7th Avenue, of all places, filled with Jews. Except the models weren't, of course. And I had felt, one of the models had asked me once about my religion, and I told her. And she was so stunned, she made a big thing of it with all the models and said, "Do you know this? Look at her. I mean, you would never believe it. She doesn't look it." And they all looked at me kind of strangely, and I felt as though I was in a cage. I thought, what is this peculiarity? And then I was subsequently fired from that position, and I thought that that had had something to do with it, because it all seemed to happen at once. Now, that may have been my own over-dramatization or overreaction to the incident, but I did not forget it. And I remember once going out with a young man from West Point who also somehow, I don't know how the religion thing came into it, but somehow then when he learned I was Jewish, he never called me again. So I attributed that to my religion, and I began to feel singled out. And everyone made such a thing of it when they discovered it, and it was though, I mean, you feel like a freak, you know, and you say, oh God, well, I mean, I just hope that, I mean, that it's the way you are, and I felt I was made conscious of it in a way that I did not like, and in a way that did not make me relax, feel at ease, or comfortable with myself. And also, I behaved in a way that did not make me proud of myself. Mm.
Because you were being secretive about it?
Yes, because, I mean, it wasn't that I would ever deny it.
No.
But I did not, certainly, out front, say, that's the way it is. I certainly didn't have the courage to do it with Howard Hawks, and I'm not proud of that.
You see, the other thing that puzzled me was, although it doesn't puzzle me in a way, I suppose, but there are those very pretty photographs of you when you were a little girl, right? And yet you seem firmly convinced, right through your life, I mean, perhaps even now I think you are, terribly self-conscious about your looks. Why? When you must have seen yourself on the screen looking wonderful, and the front of magazines you look wonderful.
Sometimes. But I don't know. I just think that it has to do with the fact that I always saw what was wrong. I always saw the crooked teeth and the imperfections. And that was what I paid attention to, as opposed to the positive things. I mean, that's my own temperament and the way I have always thought, and that's maybe one of my hang-ups and problems, but I certainly never thought I was a raving beauty, and I was not a raving beauty. I mean, I've seen raving beauties. I know what raving beauties look like. But it was, I don't think that I was hideous or ugly, but I don't think that I was, I thought I had some good qualities, and sometimes I like the way I look, but not often. And I certainly could never bear to look at myself in rushes. When you see yourself moving and acting on the screen, you want to kill yourself. It's so revolting. See everything.
But then
off.
Didn't Bogart make you feel beautiful?
Well, he made me feel terrific. Mm. Yes, he made me feel wonderful, and he gave me much more confidence in myself than I had.